So now to make this a little more interesting, let's take this code that I wrote here and convert it to a data entry script. And what I mean by that, I'll go to a different sheet. Here, I'm going to call this one form. And here, I'm going to basically add a couple of things. I'm going to enter amount, quantity, and that's pretty much it. So basically, I'll add some amount here, and then some quantity here. And what I want a button here that when I click on this, it will add this amounts and quantities to this data tab over here in this columns. Let's actually add a row here and call this like amount, this one quantity. And for this one, we'll do a timestamp. So it will tell us when this happened instead of doing line number. In order to do this, I'm going to first have to grab this information from this particular cells. So for that reason, I need access to this worksheet called form. So I'm going to go ahead and create a variable here. Now we need to give it a different name. From this form sheet, we need to get our information from these two cells. There are two options we have here. We can get this as an array, both values at the same time, but I'm just going to get each value separately for this example. So what I'll do here, I'll just access both of those values. So I'll do const amount. And for that, we'll take that form sheet. We'll get the range. And here I'll just keep it simple. I'll just do A2. And I'll do dot get value to get the value of that cell. Because it's a single cell, it's value, not values. I'm going to copy this line. And for this one, we'll do QTY for quantity. And this will be B2 cell. We'll grab the value from that cell for this. So now this amount would be the number here. QTY would be the number here. Next, let's try to get our current time. So I'll do const current time. And for this, we can use JavaScript date object to create our current date and time. Let's actually call it current date time instead of just current time. Okay, so now we should have these three variables, amount, QTY, and current date time. That's pretty much what we need to add here. We're adding that to this data tab. We already have that. We need to find our range. So it's going to find this used range. And after that, we're going to find the last row here. And then we're going to find the next row range, which is going to be this line. And finally, we're going to put those values here, comma separated, in this particular order. So we need timestamp to be the first one. So here, what I'll do, I'll use that current date time, comma. Then the second one is going to be amount. And then finally, we're going to have QTY for quantity right there. Now you can see that it's not happy about this current date time because this is actually a date object. And it says that we cannot make it a string, number, or Boolean. So we need to convert it in some way to something more readable. And we can do it either here or we can do it directly here. I'll just do it directly here. So I'm going to do dot. So these are methods on this date that we have available. So as you can see, we can set some things, we can get some things, we can basically do to date string or to this one. I don't know. I'm going to just pick one. Let's do this one for now. We'll probably get more fancy Excel-like dates as we go forward. For now, I'm going to do this. That's good enough. And save this. So now it's going to be string date, and this will stop complaining about it. So at this point, if I remember, I got these two things, 45 and this 7. So if I go ahead and run this, so let's go and check out what happened in our data tab. So as you can see, we got our date and time entered here in this weird format. And like I said, I'm not going to worry about formatting in this particular video, but you can see how we got 45 and 7 in these lines. Now, at this point, I can go here and update these to, let's say, 12 and 3, and then rerun this. And now it should enter those two things in our data tab. See, 12, 3 in our next line, just like that. It might be worth to just clear these cells after we enter that data. So basically what we can do after we set these values in our next line, we can then clear those values. Now, since I'm going to be pointing to that same A2 cell to clear it later on, I'm just going to move that range to its own line. So I'll just grab this much and do const amount range equals that. Let's get rid of this. And then I'll copy this much and do const qty range equals this. And then here, instead of doing this, I'll just use this amount range variable, which refers to this, which is the same as this. So we'll do amount range, and that same thing we'll do here with our qty range. And so far, it will just make our script work as it did. But now I can later use this amount range and qty range in my code down here. So I can do amount range dot clear, and then qty range dot clear. So that way we'll clear what's in the cell after we add it to our data tab. So before I go ahead and run this, the last thing we can do, we can add a button here. So I can go back to my previous screen over here. This is that particular script. The name for it is script 3. We could rename that to something better. And then over here, we have these three little dots. And as you can see, we have this option to add button. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And you can see it adds this button. It took a second. So now I should be able to close this. And this is my button over here. So let's just enter some number. And some number here too. I'm going to click add data. So that's going to start running the script, as you can see. So once the data is in my data tab, see, it's clearing this. So if I go to my data tab here, you can see that's in this line now. And then I can keep using this the same way as I did before. So it's going to add right there. So that should do it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.